بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إنا نرغب إليك في دولة كريمة تعز بها الإسلام وأهله، وتذل بها النفاق وأهله، وتجعلنا فيها من الدعاة إلى طاعتك والقادة إلى سبيلك، وترزقنا بها كرامة الدنيا والآخرة.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وبه نستعين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين. أما بعد، awaited savior of humanity Imam al-Mahdi عليه السلام. Respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to our 26th discussion in our series commentating upon grand du'a known as du'a al-iftitah. In our previous discussion, we looked at the entrance into the latter half of du'a al-iftitah, post the salawat upon Muhammad and Ali Muhammad. And we noted that the lines are a prayer that we can make on a regular basis for Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam, ultimately describing exactly what he will do after his appearance, the things that we hope for. Help Imam to be a caller towards your religion, the person who establishes your book. Oh Allah, assist him with your assistance, and so on and so forth. We stated that these are things that teach us about what the Imam will do and give to you and I a very perfect way to supplicate for the coming of Imam al-Mahdi, ajjalallahu ta'ala faraj al-sharif. In this next section, we begin to really speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through our heart. And having said to Allah, these are the things that we want, we really want Him to come, we really want Him to be assisted by you. The next section of the du'a now is a request and an ardent prayer, a real fervent du'a and supplication for Imam alayhi salam to go that next step. You see, the first step is for the conclusion of ghaiba and to be assisted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happens after that? Imam alayhi salam starts his movement. What happens after that? Well, it's a very interesting question, because according to the ahadith, we do have certain chronological orders or descriptions of what takes place after the dhuhur of Imam alayhi salam. For example, we find that the Imam alayhi salam starts his movement by the Kaaba. We also find that thereafter he may go towards Iraq, and in particular he may go to Masjid Sahla and set up his house or his governance from that place. Elsewhere, we also find hadith that will say to us, for example, that Imam will begin to move against some of the Arab communities. And in particular, one hadith says that he will be very harsh upon the Arabs. And one can reflect upon that and imagine that if Imam alayhi salam comes today, when it comes to corrupt regimes such as Saudi Arabia, such as Bahrain, we have others throughout the Middle East. For example, we have today in Egypt, many of these countries that are working with open enemies of Islam, funding open enemies of Islam, and have so much enmity towards Islam despite being Muslims, you can see that through the practice, they have become people that would not be defeated just through a call. It may be that Imam alayhi salam has to be very harsh upon them. After that, some narrations tell us that Imam alayhi salam would go towards Jerusalem and free Jerusalem. Now, that again is very interesting, because if Imam alayhi salam comes in today's context, Jerusalem is occupied by the illegal and illegitimate regime of Israel or occupied Palestine. Now that suggests to us that Imam alayhi salam has to be able to challenge the status quo that is present that we find today in the Arab world and also within the illegal state of Israel. And only through removing these sorts of evils off the face of the earth can the world really be free and come to a state in which it is a just world. This is very interesting because it shows to us that how you and I may perceive what is taking place in the world today. There are many Shias that consider the issue of the illegal state of Israel as a political issue. Actually, it's an issue of justice. And the fact that Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam, according to the hadith, in the beginning of his movement, seeks to free Jerusalem from occupation, shows to us how important it is in the mind of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the presence of the divine of Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam. If it is that important in the eyes of the divine, it shows to you and I how important it should be in our eyes as well. Yet there are many Muslims and many Shia consider this just to be a political issue or something that we should not get involved with. Ultimately, these are very important points for you and I to be able to reflect on. Having seen this chronology, the dua then says, what happens next? We've asked for him to come, we've asked for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to assist him. Now what? The dua continues in the chronology of events. It says, Allahumma inna narghabu ilayka fi dawlatin kareemah tu'izzu biha al-islam wa ahla wa tudhillu biha an-nifaq wa ahla wa taj'aluna fiha min ad-da'ati ila ta'atik wal qadati ila sabilik wa tarzuqana biha karamat ad-dunya wal akhirah. Now here what we are asking for is, O Allah, we ardently desire there to be dawlatin kareemah, a just and honorable state, tu'izzu biha al-islam wa ahla, so that it does what? It honors Islam and its folk. Wa tudhillu biha an-nifaq wa ahla, and that this state should do what? Humble, humiliate, remove nifaq, hypocrisy from the face of this world, wa ahla, and its people and its folk and its like. Now this is very interesting because today you and I live in a world of a dawla, not dawla til kareema, but dawla nonetheless. There is one called dawla til islamiyya, which is known as Islamic State or ISIS or ISIL. Look at the difference. Here we pray for dawla, we pray for a state, but we don't pray for the type of state that is created today. Neither the nation state, a country which is a state based on nifaq, a state based on hypocrisy or evil or torture or whatever the types of states that are present in the world today. Nor do we ask for the type of Islamic state that is present from Daesh and from ISIS. Allahumma inna narghabu ilayka fi dawlatin kareema. We ask for an honorable state in the hands of Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam. Now this is very interesting because there are many people that are secular Muslims. What do they want? They want to divide church and state. They want to say, yeah, we have state, but Islam shouldn't have anything to do with it. We're Muslims, yeah, we pray, we fast, but we don't want Islam to actually govern the way in which we live. How interesting a concept that we have found ourselves today within Islam. Here the dua says we should be desirous of a dawla which is honorable in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that calls towards Islam and its people and destroys nifaq and its type of people. So here this shows us the concept of secularism within Islam, that our ideal should be an honorable state from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here the heart really should be yearning for this. We are really begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the coming of Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam. We ask for the honorable state, that it honors Islam and its people, that it destroys hypocrisy and its type. Now this is very interesting as well, because if you reflect very deeply on this, you will find the following. you will see that nifaq is hypocrisy. What type of hypocrisy? A hypocrisy of Muslims, right? Those people who are believers in Islam, externally, but internally they don't really believe, or they cause doubts and cause problems in the Muslim community. What is this called? Nifaq. Wa ahla, and its people. Meaning that we want Allah to remove, to humiliate those people who claim outwardly on their tongue Islam, but internally they have nothing to do with it. Wa ahla, and its people, and its like, and those people who are like that. Which means that actually we are praying for those Muslims who are causing the downfall of Islam to be removed from us. And what are we asking for from the opposite? Muslims, wa ahlahu, and its like, and their people, and their folk, to be honored. This means Islam and their like, non-Muslims, to be honored within this state. Why again is this important? Because again, we have people of Daesh mentality, Saudi and Salafiyya mentality, that believe that we are completely exclusive, that we have to destroy everyone who doesn't believe the way you and I believe. This is completely alien to Islam altogether. And it is here within the du'a that we find it. Allahumma inna narghabu ilayka fi dawlatin kareema. We want an honorable state. What type of honorable state? Tu'izzu biha al-Islam wa ahla. Muslims, Islam is honored, and other than Muslims are also honored in it. What do we want to be swept away? Nifaq wa ahla. Those Muslims that are completely egregious in their sins, destroying Islam, wa ahla, and the people like that who are also doing the same as Muslims who are destroying Islam externally and internally. This is what we are praying for within this du'a. Very profound meaning, very profound depth to it, that one needs to reflect on when we recite it. Inshallah, it comes from the heart and it begins to transform you and I in the way in which we understand, the way in which we practice our religion, and see Imam al-Mahdi and the mission, the global movement of Imam al-Mahdi. Ajjalallahu ta'ala faraja al-sharif walhamdulillah rabbil alameen wa salli ya rabbi ala Muhammad wa alihi al-tahireen.